Nobody bleeds Bucknell baseball quite like this guy. In his eighth year as pitching coach, I'm joined by Jason Neitz. Jason, baseball season right around the corner. Got to be excited.
Absolutely. We got a tough schedule ahead of us to start the season out, but feeling really good about our preparation. Obviously, the weather hasn't been conducive to get outside, but you know, we're able to get a lot of work in here in the field house and get the pitchers ready with building a pitch count and everything inside. So it's been really good.
You're anchored by Pitcher of the Year, Connor Van Hoos, in the preseason. What makes him so special?
You know, Connor is a guy that goes out and competes from pitch one and has a good trust in everything that he throws. You know, he's not really going to overpower you, but he's got three pitches for strikes that he can throw at any time. He doesn't fall behind hitters, and when he does, which is very seldom, he is able to bounce back and, you know, force weak contact and let the defense work for him.
Jack Graybeck and Jeff Gottesman have such a high ceiling. What can they do their junior year to get back to their freshman year form?
Well, you know, it's just comes down to consistency, and we worked a lot on mechanical flaws that they had in their deliveries a little bit this, you know, in the fall as far as in bullpen settings, just to get them to a point where they were throwing more consistent strikes. Stuff-wise, they've always been really, really good and been able to compete when they're on, but, you know, the consistency part is really the big thing that they need to figure out this year.
Jack Simpson, 6 foot, he's like an offensive lineman on the hill. He changed his body, though. He looks a lot leaner, right?
Jack, he transformed his body quite a bit this summer, right, and really took a big step in the right direction with that. And, you know, it's kind of one of the things that a body that big, we don't really want him to lose too much of that weight, but he's kind of tightened it up and has worked really, really hard to do that and has seen gains with both strength and velocity. So,
how do you see your bullpen playing out here in 2018?
It's going to shake itself out in the first couple of weeks. There's a lot of things that are still kind of undetermined, but a lot of talented young guys and some returners that we feel that are going to be able to contribute at a high level. And in order for us to be successful, we're going to need that.
Yeah, it's such a great year last year. How much do you think about that Holy Cross series? How much did that resonate in the back of your mind to fuel you this offseason?
It comes down to, you know, one inning. We were one inning away there. And, you know, unfortunately, it was Jeff Gottesman that was on the mound when that happened. But it's fueled him so much, you know, moving forward through the summer. And he kind of took some time off and worked on his body, worked on resting his arm and everything, and had a great fall and has been really driven. And it's paying dividends so far. So,
you were standout at Mifflinburg High School, eighth year here at Bucknell. How would you define the Bucknell Bison baseball culture?
You know, it's still rising. And I think that the footprint that Coach Heather and myself are putting in is a yearly thing. The personnel this year is really good. There's a great team camaraderie this year. And I think that that in itself speaks volumes for where we're going. You know, you just got to continue to get better and every day come out to the field and have something that you want to get better at to make yourself, at the end of the day, the best team that you can.
Nobody can dissect mechanics like you. One of these teams is going to get a great head coach one day, but we're so glad to have you at Bucknell.
I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
That was Jason Neitz. I'm Justin Antweil. I'm just as excited as Jason. More ahead here on BucknellBison.com.